everyone, welcome to Living a Country. I'm Holly, and today we have a farmhouse home decor haul, and I'm really excited to share these items in the shop with you guys. These items are from Vintage Farmhouse Finds, and they put together this beautiful collection of items, and when I received it, I was absolutely blown away, you guys, because these items actually fit my style and richen up my home so much. I was in disbelief. It almost made me feel like, wow, like they need to come up with like a bundle or something like that where they put these all together, and maybe they do, I don't know, but they bundled everything for like a kitchen dining room area. These items are so high quality. They almost have a, I would say, a boho farmhouse, modern farmhouse kind of vibe, and I'm telling you guys, I love these items. I've already started using probably about 90% of the items, and so excited to share it with you guys. You've already seen a few in my home because I started decorating with them right away, but my favorite has to be this faux tree. Let me show you guys. Okay, so right here we have this faux plant. I seriously love this. It fits perfectly into one of their pottery pieces that they sent this way. I'm gonna share what that looks like. Okay, here is the pottery. I'm gonna put it right into here. You guys, this is something like, I have it in my office and I put it right on top of my desk area. You guys, it's so stinking beautiful. I love this. My mom came over and was like, oh my gosh, your home those pieces of decor look amazing. So my mom noticed it right away. My husband's like, that's something you would never pick, but it looks so good. And I really couldn't give myself credit. I was like, well, I didn't pick the pieces. So thank you to Vintage Farmhouse Finds for picking these beautiful, beautiful pieces. You're actually gonna see a video coming up very soon of my friend and I, Charlie, decorating with the same pieces. And we're gonna see how we can style them very differently, but with the same pieces. So it's gonna be a fun collaboration, so make sure you're subscribed for that. But I have to say, this was my favorite items together. And you guys, I just love it. I love being challenged, I think would be the correct word to use. But this really made me think about my style and being like, I should try other things and seeing how I like it. A lot of you might not know this, but I went from a very, I wouldn't say primitive style. I tried really, really hard to have like a primitive country style when I lived in our tiny house, which I will link right above here. A lot of people don't realize we lived 6 years in a tiny house under 400 square feet. 200 square feet of it was an office space and the rest was living area. So we went from tiny house to this house, and it was quite a transition. It still mentally is a transition because I went from such a tiny space to 1,800 square feet, 1,900 square feet. And so although that might be an average size of a home, my home feels very, very large to me still. So I went from a primitive style home and tried transitioning out of that to a farmhouse because that was the style I liked, and that's the style I still like. So I'm trying to still get better. I like bringing farmhouse inspiration to you all, but I am still learning myself. But I hope you guys enjoy me sharing these things with you. I also forgot to mention, it came with a miniature version of this. I haven't figured out what I wanna do with this yet. I might just put it on like a shelf behind here with nothing in it. I don't have any faux plants big enough to go in here, but I'm so excited. I'm so excited to think outside of the box. I'd love to know in the comment section down below, was there a piece of decor or pieces of decor you ever purchased that you never thought you would like, but you ended up loving? That happened with me with a shower curtain I bought. I was like, oh, this is like not my style. And then I put it in my kids' bathroom and I fell so in love with it. I ended up buying one for our master bathroom too. So sometimes buying things and being creative and thinking outside the box can lead to a passion or just a hobby or even a full-time career, I guess. But that's my fun story, and I'd love to hear yours in the comments below. Okay, so the next piece is this beautiful table runner. It has this mustard yellow color, and it's a checkered. It's buffalo checkered. Buffalo checkered. And it's got just this frayy look, and you guys, I love this. This richens up my farmhouse table. It looks so adorable. I love it. It's been on my table with my huge farmhouse candle that I barely light, just so you guys know. I have had quite a few questions about that. I actually just light it for special occasions, and the last time I lit it was, I think, for my farmhouse tour, and then the time previously was for my son's birthday back in February. So it's, I don't light it. That's why I still have it. So I love this table runner. I switched it out from my Target table runner that I had. It was a ticking stripe one that I got for like $2. And I have not put it back on my table. So I might redo my kids' table, their farmhouse table, and put that on there. But I love this, you guys. It adds a little bit of color, especially for spring and summer, and I love it. Okay, so the next items, there's two of them, and they are some decorative trays, and I'm really excited about these. I have had a plastic tray for the longest time for when my family is sick, and we put it on there, and not that we're gonna use this for when we're sick. I actually plan on putting these on our coffee table when we get a coffee table, because a lot of people don't know that we still have not finished our home, and we are decorating it very slowly. We wanna stay on a budget, and we wanna get things done slowly, just so we stay on budget. So anyways, these are gonna look perfect on there, and I'm so excited. I'll probably use one of them. The bigger one, I'm thinking, on the coffee table, and then the smaller one, I've seen a lot of people do this, and I think it's so cute. It's not realistic, in my opinion, where they put it at the end of the bed with a lit candle, and I think it's so cute if there was like a guest room or something like that. In fact, I know what I'm gonna do with it. I am not gonna put it on my master bed. I'm gonna put it on my mom's guest bed. We are in the middle of doing a DIY guest bedroom makeover, my husband and I, for my mom's house for when my brother and my sister-in-law stay over. And this is gonna be perfect because I have some extra candles. I'm so excited now, put some candy. So I'm so excited, you guys, this is fun. So you guys are helping me while I talk to you guys through the camera, you guys are helping me. So that's wonderful. Thank you guys. So we're gonna decorate this for that guest room. So now I am super, super excited. So my next question for you was gonna be, what should I do with these gorgeous dishes? They're stackable. I love the color. It's like a really, really, it's like a white with like this purpley bluish color, kind of like my shirt. But I know what I'm gonna do with it. I'm gonna maybe put some little mints in it for the end of the bed. So that's gonna be really cute. And then the next item are these garland beads, and these kind of have that same feel. And I didn't know what I was gonna do with these, and now I totally do. And you guys, I know it sounds so silly, but sometimes just literally talking out loud helps me kind of think of ideas. I don't know, are you guys the same way? But I get ideas as I'm talking, and so, I don't know. You guys helped me, and so thank you. I know it sounds so funny, I don't know. Maybe I'm funny like that. But I'm gonna put these in this little tray like that, and I think it's gonna look so, so cute. And last but not least, we have these tea towels, and there's a couple of different designs, I think. I think there's three of them in here, and I don't know if I'm the only person that's like this. I hate taking tea towels out of the packaging because this looks so cute, right? So I use all my tea towels. I know a lot of people will only use them for their dining room table, for like display, to be nice, to look nice, or they'll use it on their ovens or around their, you know, farmhouse sinks. And I use my tea towels. I don't have a single one that I have not used because I'm a person who, why am I gonna have it if it's not like multifunctional, you know? So, well, if it's not, you know what I mean? So, I know I should use these, but I might do something cute with them. Maybe in the tray, I don't know. You guys are gonna have to stay tuned and subscribe, but I think these are so cute, and I'm so excited to just start getting creative, and this has definitely opened my eyes to like a whole new world of decor. So I'm really, really excited about it. So a big thank you to Vintage Farmhouse Finds for putting the collection together. That was so, so kind of you guys to do. Make sure you guys check them out down in the description box below. And make sure before you guys leave to hit that subscribe button and notification bell. I'll see you guys later on Limited Country. Bye.